put a nice combination together.
You see him block the big shot right there from Stanford. He's looking, even though he's not punching, he's looking for the shot that he wants. See his gloves up, he's looking, and then boom! That shot was set up because Stanford is throwing big shots. You see the guard of Holyfield up, but he's looking for an opportunity to land the shot. Let's watch it right here. He's looking, block. He didn't take it that time. He said, let me be patient. He's still throwing. I know he's open. Block, miss, jab. You see him looking? Boom! Set that shot up right there. It only takes one with a follow-up right hand for good measure. It's a great sequence. We'll focus on the knockout, but we got to focus on what set up the left hook.
And that moment right there must be priceless for Evander Holyfield. Like I said, the only one of his 11 children to follow in his footsteps.
Man,
he got a
kids.
Son, Elijah, who was an NFL running back. But this has got to feel special for Evander because his own blood is in there. And it's not just some kid who is just trying to follow in his father's footsteps. He said, my mother wanted me to do everything but fight. In spite of my father, in spite of my mother not doing this, I want to do this for myself. And this young kid is going to build up a great fan base right here in Atlanta, Georgia. Let's send it up to Mark Chinook for the official time of the knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, here inside State Farm Arena, Atlanta, Georgia, this bout comes to a conclusion at 30 seconds of round number two for your winner by knockout, Evan Young Holyfield!
8-0, six victories by knockout for this 6'2" athlete who's blessed with power and a great pedigree. The young Holyfield with the left hand that stunned him and the right to the temple that finished Charles Stanford. We'll come back with more from Atlanta, leading up to Harry Stevenson.